าเลเซียมีนโยบายส่งเสริมการอ่านจากภาครัฐและมีการส่งเสริมให้มีการอ่านทั้งในโรงเรียนและบริษัทเอกชนศาสตราจารย์แอมบิกาปาตีปานเดียนอาจารย์ด้านการศึกษาและภาษาศาสตร์บอกว่าเอเชียเป็นสังคมวัฒนธรรมแห่งการพูดส่วนตะวันตกเป็นวัฒนธรรมแห่งการอ่าน
Professor, do Malaysians in general read less today?
Not really. As I said, it depends on how you define reading. If you look at the social media and if they are reading their handphones, their messages, if they are reading tablets, they are reading iPads, you know, so I think the reading culture has actually improved. And this is partly because of the intervention programs taken by the government, by the schools, and interestingly by certain private organizations too in Malaysia. For example, in schools we have specific reading programs embedded within the language classrooms where students are made to go to the library, where students are now asked to read books and then to record the books that they've read and then to share with their friends, and that is one activity to summarize.
Now some people might think reading is something for academics or students to do, but then not for me to do, because I just go on with my daily life, I do my job, I know how to do it. Why do I need to read more?
Well, actually you are reading and you're still not reading. I'll give you an example. Okay, for school, for exams, I read. When I go out, I don't read. But when you look at the street of the, you know, signs of the street, are you not reading? You know, when you go to work, what about newspapers when you read? Are you not reading? I did a study in 1997, because in Malaysia, to be specific, the focus was on reading skills. So we find that we got 100% literacy already in Malaysia now. But people are not continuing reading. And I call this reading reluctancy a phenomena, a reluctancy phenomena. Reading reluctancy simply means people who can read but they don't read. And there's no difference between people who can read and don't read and people who cannot read. Because many studies, including mine, has shown that reading models has an influence on reading. Meaning, if I read and I go home and I read to my children, or if I sit and read, my children will also start reading. Because reading is caught, it is not taught. I don't have to tell my children to read. I start reading, my wife starts reading, my other family members start reading, they will read. It's all caught. Schools, you see teachers reading, the students will read. The problem is teachers say, go and read. Father says, go and read. How to read? You are not reading. Because I don't see role models. So the implication is, when people who can read and don't read, they are going to create another generation of non-readers. Because reading models has an effect on reading.
Is it a national policy of Malaysia to encourage people to read?
It is through the Ministry of Education. It's a national policy. Firstly, to make sure that 100% of the population is literate. And now with people like me and my other friends, to make sure that this reading continues. That is the next challenge. As I said earlier, in the 50s, 60s, 70s, even 80s, it was just reading skill, just to read. So we thought, once the moment I teach you how to read, you will continue reading. But that is not true. So now we are trying to go to the second phase of encouraging to read. So how do we do that? We take an approach of reading as a social process, not reading for cognitive, individual. You know, they said you want a friend, the best friend is a book, because one-to-one. That must change. Now we talk about social pattern, socialization with book. What do I mean by that? Get five friends, five people read books, maybe the same book, then we come and share ideas about the book.
So if the majority of the population don't really read or read less, would that country become dumber?
Yes, yes. That's what studies have shown. Why do people in America read? Because everybody's reading. They got the reading culture. But in our Asian culture, Malaysia, Thailand, we talk. We got the oral culture. And suddenly, heart attack, we die. All of our good ideas go 6 feet under. That's the problem. Actually, there are diamonds of ideas all 6 feet under.
รองศาสตราจารย์เซติโอโนสุกิฮาโตะอาจารย์ประจำภาควิชาภาษาอังกฤษคณะศึกษาศาสตร์มหาวิทยาลัยแอดมาจายะคาทอลิกในจาการ์ตาประเทศอินโดนีเซียบอกว่า รัฐบาลอินโดนีเซียไม่มีนโยบายส่งเสริมการอ่านอย่างเป็นรูปธรรมมีเพียงการติดป้ายรณรงค์ให้อ่านหนังสือหรือพ่อแม่จะเป็นคนบอกลูกให้อ่านหนังสือเสียมากกว่าอุปสรรคที่คนอินโดนีเซียจะอ่านหนังสือน้อยก็คือหนังสือราคาแพง
What are some of the policies that the government put in place to encourage reading?
The government just simply you know put the banners on the street showing Mari membaca, let's read, something like that.
It's like a campaign.
It's a sort of campaign, but the governments also, the local governments also provided the so-called mobile libraries. But most of the community libraries using the fund of non-government organs. So basically what I'd like to emphasize is that people now began to become aware of the importance of reading.
Does Indonesia have enough libraries across the country?
I have no specific data how many libraries are there in Indonesia actually. But in my observations, only in big cities that we have a lot of libraries.
But for big cities, do people actually go to the libraries to read?
Yes, in many places, but you don't have many people have false impressions that as if our children, our people do not really go to the library. Actually, they do. But the problem, as I told you before, is that children educational policy in Indonesia does not really stand on the right track. That is because they give the impressions that if you want to be able to read, you have to read very demanding texts, academic texts, school textbooks. I think that creates a very false impression. Children are actually like reading, they love reading, but do not impose them at the very beginning by reading textbooks, which I think is very cognitively burdensome for them.
Mm-hmm. Are books expensive in Indonesia?
Books are very expensive. So that's why, as I told you, only those coming from high income family can read books, can enjoy access to books, and the children from this rich family can develop literacy faster than those coming from low income family.
When we say read, which type of books are we referring to?
Yes, from my experience, my own experience, and from my own observation, I have come to realize that books which the students like, we have to encourage the so-called free voluntary reading, reading for pleasure. So light reading such as comics, teen romances, for instance, and then novels, teen magazines, something like that. That is called light reading.
Mm-hmm. For you as an academic, yes. When you say let's encourage reading, what type of reading or what type of books would you like to see people to read more?
We have to see case per case in this case. We cannot simply generalize. What I would like to highlight is that let people read whatever they want.